Our next speaker, ladies and gentlemen, is someone who scales new dizzying heights every year and empowers scores of Indians to do quite literally the same. He's a lawyer turned president of India's most profitable low-fare airline, but that he claims was just the result of being at the right place at the right time. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the president of IndiGo Airlines, Aditya Ghosh.
Thanks very much, Sharon. When we kind of started up IndiGo, we asked ourselves a few questions. So the first one we really asked was, you know, what is our one big objective? We were dumb enough to say that at IndiGo, we were the last airline to start. So, you know, by the time we started, all the pilots were gone and the engineers were gone, the parking bays were gone, and people were asking us, so you've ordered 100 planes, where are you going to park them? And the perception when we talked about starting a low-fare airline was often low-cost kind of equated to low-quality. I remember instances when, you know, I would see people come off a low-fare carrier and then quietly, discreetly, they'll take their bag tag off, you know, and didn't want to say that, you know, which airline they flew. So we said, okay, our one big objective, we just don't want low-cost to be low-quality. 2006, and you know, the airline business is booming, and guess what? 2009 arrives, and the worst year in the airline business ever, right? And all the passengers are disappearing, and you know, people are crying foul. So we had to be constantly agile and change our product and suddenly accelerate, you know, fleet coming in. While the entire industry was screaming over capacity, IndiGo started adding planes. In the same year, when the overall market dipped by 5%, IndiGo grew by 46%. And then the next year, we grew by another 39%. And this year, we'll grow by another 50%. So we just had to kind of look at ourselves, and as Kiran was saying, kind of look at ourselves and say, hey, you know, what are we doing? And what do we need to do differently so that we don't lose track of that dream, but yet we can be, you know, agile. But you know what? When we were starting up, we were kind of losing focus. Because everybody around us was throwing valets and carpets and free meals and chocolate mousse and, like, you know, and I was like, oh my God, are we doing the right thing or not? And, you know, we thought of a typical travel plan. Okay, you know, these are three simple things that we're going to chase: on time, hassle-free, low fares, and that's the business model that works for us. Now the problem that you have, or we had, was it's just not enough to be competitive. It is not enough to be better than the next loser. So we went and ordered 100 planes back in 2005. When we ordered 100 planes, I remember the press was saying, this is not really true, this is a marketing gimmick, where are you going to park these planes? These planes are really not going to come. They're going to run a trading company, they're going to take these planes and sell them off, or, you know, something else. They're not going to fly these planes in India. Who flies 100 planes in India, right? But we said, we'll take 100 planes. India is one of the most under-penetrated aircraft markets in the world. So we spread them over a period of 10 years. On the 10th of October, next month, I actually get delivery of my 50th plane. So I'm halfway through this order now. And we're only 5 years into our business plan. And the 100th aircraft arrives in 2015. So while we are growing and the other guys are shrinking, 4 years will go by like that. So 2015, I've eaten up my first 100 planes, what am I going to do next? So we went and ordered another 180. We had to time it. So we knew we needed planes, but just getting more of the same planes with that technology that is already existing today would have put us at a competitive disadvantage. That is not the structural advantage that we could have worked on. So on the 1st of December last year, Airbus announces this new plane called the Neo. It's a 320, just like ours. It has a different engine and winglets. Immediately, we have a plane which burns almost up to less than 15% less fuel than our current planes. And those planes arrive from 2015 onwards, the same time that our first 100 come to an end. So it just dovetailed perfectly. And that creates that unique structural advantage. This is a marathon. You've got to keep that long-term vision in mind. I run a half marathon in my life, And all I know is the only way that you can make it to the finishing line is not being of a consistent speed, but knowing when to speed up and knowing when to conserve energy. We have a long way to go, and probably too early to kind of say success for us, but I know we're on the right track because, you know, 4,100 other people in my company feel the same way. Thanks very much.
Aditya, thank you very, very much.
Sula today is the largest wine producer, yes, the most premium wine producer, but what to me is the most important thing is that my dream has now become the dreams of thousands of people.